A typical day, I wake up in the morning and the first thing as a habit, I would grab my phone and check my emails to see if there's any urgent emails or tasks that has transpired overnight. Because of the time difference between my office here and in Washington, D.C., definitely when I'm sleeping, they're working. So there's definitely movement while I'm sleeping. So just trying to understand if there's any urgent tasks that I need to focus on. Then I'll have breakfast. I love coffee, so I drink my coffee, go to work. As soon as I go to work, I will ask my team members to sit with me so we can talk about the priority for the day. And any urgent task that needs to be assigned, I'll assign. And then most of my mornings are spent meeting, trying to see, for instance, if we're working on an election law, we look at the election law, what needs to be done, if there's a revision, if there's copy edit, if there's any consultation that needs to be done, we do it. And then if we're working on a curriculum for training, we review the curriculum, we incorporate any feedback, and then I'll talk about it in the morning. And in the afternoon, during lunch, I usually work, but this is like a social work thing where I meet different people, whether women CSO partners or somebody from the international community. I usually try to use my lunch for working, but also for socializing so I can exchange information about the work that we do. Then in the afternoon, most of the time, I work on action points, for instance, any task that I need to do. If I need to write a speech, if I need to do a concept note for a program, if I need to develop a manual, whatever needs to be done in the afternoon, usually afternoons are done for working. And then by 4 p.m. when DC wakes up, then we typically have calls with DC, coordination calls. So by 6 p.m., I would wind up my day and I try to socialize as much as I can in the evening, meet friends for drinks or for dinner. And I think by 10 p.m., I wrap up my day.